portfolio strategy be? So what is the sort of allocation that they're looking at? And then we'll of course talk about real estate, because that's the other asset class most of us like, or shouldn't like.
So what should your strategy be? Your strategy should be to have 60% in equity, 40% in debt or debt-like instruments. If you have 60% in debt, of course, I'm oversimplifying stuff. Once in the strategy, you need to decide your asset allocation. 60-40 is a fair asset allocation. Why is it a fair asset allocation? Because if equity markets fall further by 25%, okay, which is the extreme case, your debt will earn you so much money. Coming back to the good news, which country is allowing you to earn debt returns of 9%? So if you put 60% in equity, 40% in debt, the next 3 years debt return will be a cushion for your equity. That's point one. Point two, always remember, in my opinion, in our opinion, let me call it that way, that you need to, in small things in life, you have a plan A and a plan B. Most portfolios are always designed assuming that the portfolio creator will go right. We might say equity is good, but there could be something which can be an unforeseen event if there's a war. So you should have a plan A and plan B. So what are your plan Bs? Plan B, by which I mean, we believe in one plan B, which is called the structure product. So we put 30% of our clients' monies at least in a structure product, which is a plan B, and plan A is mutual funds. Asset allocation 60-40. If you don't have 30% to 40% in structures, which is a mechanical way of managing money without emotions, then you don't have a plan B. If you don't use this as your plan B, you need to use something else as your plan B. There are 5-7 plan Bs available. After a lot of deliberation, 6 years back, we chose structure product as the plan B. So this is the recommended allocation. Sorry, a longer answer than you would have expected.
Also,